church on this Palm Sunday. You might ask, do all of you have a palm? We're going to have a procession with palms. And you are all invited to join us, but especially the children. Okay? And if you have a child who can't walk yet, too young, have a parent carry the child, and we'll have a great procession. And if we get stuck somewhere, you know, like we did one year, I've got my traffic cop here that can keep us going. A couple of announcements, since we got the procession. Oh yeah, also we're singing a song, Kenny is leading us on a song today, and we're singing a song called Blessed He Is He Who Comes in the Name of the Lord. And it says, song by Johnny Harrison, but we put the words up on our screen, so you all can join in on that song too. When you kind of get the hang of it, just feel free to join in. Good Friday. We have one service this week, a midweek service, that is, and that's on Good Friday. You know, I didn't know what the COVID situation would be by that time, so I kind of wanted to limit the number of services we had in any one week. So I chose Good Friday because that is absolutely necessary when connected to Easter. Without Good Friday, there is no Easter. And without Easter, there is no Good Friday. That's why it's called good. So that's why we're having the Good Friday service for this week. Oh, Easter Sunday. Two services, I hope. One at 8:30 and one at 10 o'clock. If the weather cooperates, the 8:31 will be outdoors. The outdoors. I hope it's not as cold as this, that's for sure. And if not, we'll bring you both indoors. But I don't want anybody to get a cold. So that's why we're kind of dividing up the Easter service to limit the number of people at any one time. And at that Easter service, or in between the Easter services, there will be an Easter egg hunt starting approximately at, 9:30, Anna?
Yeah.
About 9:30?
Yeah.
Good. Now, are there any other announcements? Yes. Oh, yes. If you have a vaccination card, you can take it to Staples and they will laminate it for free. You want to have it laminated. So, just want to make it available to you.
Pastor, I heard that you're not supposed to get them laminated. Because if they add another booster shot, they're going to put that at the bottom on that same card.
Oh, really?
That's what I heard.
And is that kind of the official stance from the government, I guess?
That is a stance that I heard from my daughter to tell me don't get my card laminated.
I like that. Yeah.
For that reason. She gave me that reason.
Is that right? Okay. Yeah, I think there is some spaces for the vaccinations. Yeah, that's true. Okay. Forget that I said that.
We already had ours done.
Well, but anyway.
Now, are there any other announcements? Yes. I can't
understand. Easter
egg candy.
We eat Easter eggs.
Do we eat Easter eggs? No. Over the candy?
I mean, you can if you want. If not, I'll just handle it. It's up to you.
Okay. Also, when we bring
the
lettuce
Friday?
Yes. Well, we're going to have to
fry it. Well, usually we bring them Friday evening.
Evening, and then to set them up later. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Oh, and if you want to, for the processional, if you want to keep your palm, you're welcome to do that. If you don't want to keep your palm, there's this basket up here. It has some sometimes as you go around, just put it in a little basket. And we will use them, what's ever left over, for the ashes for the next Ash Wednesday service. All right. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Mercifully assist us, O Lord of our salvation, that we may with joy remember and think about those mighty acts whereby you have given us life everlasting. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
When Jesus and the disciples were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it,' and will send it back immediately." Here. They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. And as they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We praise and thank you, O God, for the great acts of love by which you have set us free through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. On this day, he entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was acclaimed Son of David and King of Kings by those who scattered their garments and branches of palm in his path. We ask that you bless these branches and those who bear them, and grant that we may hail him as our Lord and King, and follow him with perfect confidence through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
We'll just come down the center aisle and then circle around him.
Thank you.
Bring the children, please. Bring the children down, please. Before we engage in the megaphones, because we are going to use them, I wanted to tell you a little bit about Jesus' entry into Jerusalem. Now, Jesus, he came on an animal, right? He rode an animal into Jerusalem, and what was that animal? Anybody know? It was a donkey.
Hee-haw! Hee-haw!
And now, you have to wonder, now why, that this is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, right? Why in the world would he ride on a donkey rather than on a nice, big, white stallion? That's kind of an animal a king would ride in on, right? And he did that because Jesus was a very special kind of a king. He was the kind of a leader who served people. He once said, I didn't come to be served, I came to serve. And that's what the donkey represented. Kind of a servant, being a servant. And not looking at yourself as above others, but with them and serving them. That's why he rode in on a donkey. Now for the song. Okay, now this is what you're going to do. Okay, go ahead, next slide. I want you to repeat after me. All right, everyone, repeat after me. Blessed is. The one. Who comes in?
The name of. The Lord.
And then put your microphones up to your mouths and say, Hosanna!
Hosanna!
Hosanna! Shout it out.
Hosanna!
All right, let's go through that one more time. Blessed is.
The one.
Who comes in? The name of.
And I believe.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Sovereign God, you have established your rule in the human heart through the servanthood of Jesus Christ. By your Spirit, keep us in the joyful procession of those who with their tongues confess Jesus as Lord, and with their lives praise him as Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading is from the Old Testament prophet Zechariah. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you, triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem. And the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Please read responsibly with me from Psalm 122. I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Our feet are standing within the gates of Jerusalem.
Jerusalem, built as a city that is bound firmly together.
To it the tribes of the Lord, as we decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord.
Our second reading is from the New Testament letter of Paul's letter to the Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form. He humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I wanted to show a little video. I chose this, it's a roller coaster, and I chose this because it comes from Cedar Point, which is in Sandusky, Ohio, which was the closest theme park, big theme park, to where I grew up in Detroit, Michigan. I just had to take it. I searched lots of videos of roller coasters, and there were some that were perhaps better, but I had to go there and see them. So let's see this video. It may take a moment to retrieve. It's called the Steel Vengeance.
Thank you.
preaches, he's on. We're terrified. When I read the passage for today, this Jesus ride into Jerusalem, I thought of his ministry, his life, being like a roller coaster ride, up and down, with twists and turns. For example, early in his ministry, he assigns 12 disciples to be his core group of people. And it says he went up a mountain, and out of the disciples, there were many more that were there, he chose 12 to be what he would call apostles. And right after that, he comes back down, and he encounters a situation where his family is, he goes back to his hometown, and his family is there, and his family comes to him and tries to restrain him because he's healing people. And people were saying, well, he's doing that, he's casting out demons by the power of the greatest demon of all, Satan. Now, when he healed the person before, he was applauded. He said, what authority this is? What teaching he has? He even commands the demons, and they obey him. And now they're accusing him of being subject to the demons, the biggest one. Say, it's kind of a plunge, don't you think, after going up that mountain? Also, the Mountain of Transfiguration, we heard about that a little bit earlier this year, and Jesus takes Peter and James and John and goes up to that mountain, and he's transfigured before them, his clothes become white, his endoblech bleach could bleach them, his face becomes shining with the glory of God. There's Moses and Elijah with him, and gosh, they even hear God's voice say, listen to him. My beloved son, high point, gotta be a high point, not only for Jesus, but for the disciples who are with him. And he comes back down the mountain, and the first thing he encounters is the rest of the disciples, and they cannot heal a young man who is stricken with the kind of demon that convulses him. And Jesus says, oh, faithless generation, how long am I to put up with you? How long am I to be with you? And then today, he comes into Jerusalem. And Jerusalem is actually on kind of a mountain called Mount Zion. And he goes up to Jerusalem, and the people are shouting, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. And within a week, those same people are saying, crucify him, crucify him. And he is crucified on the cross, he dies. And he is buried in a tomb. You think that's a roller coaster ride? No. Roller coasters not only have ups and downs, they also have twists and turns, too. Jesus, oh my goodness, Jesus. What a twist it was when the person in his disciples' band that was most trusted in Judas, because he had the treasury, turns around and betrays him. Kind of a twist, isn't it? Do we face ups and downs in life, too? Twists and turns? I think so. And sometimes there are circumstances that are thrust upon us, and you go up and down with the circumstances. And we really don't have much control over them. But then there are those things that we kind of bring on ourselves, too. There's a man by the name of Horville Sash. And the company he worked for, he worked in the basement of the company, and he was the mail clerk. And there was not many positions any lower than Horville's. And he was discouraged. And one day, a bug crept along in front of him, and he was about to smash it with his foot. And the bug spoke and said, spare me, and I will grant you your fondest wishes. And Horville spared him and said, I want to get off this basement. I want to go to the first floor. Work on the first floor. Zap! Boom! He was up on the first floor. No longer be able to open a salesman. He wasn't quite satisfied with that because he looked up and he saw a hole in the ceiling. And he heard shuffling on the floor in the ceiling. And he knew that there was a floor above his. I want to go to the second floor. He bought the bucket. I want to go to the second floor. Zap, boom, second floor. Now he's the sales manager. And he keeps asking the bucket to go to a higher floor. And with each advancement, he gets an advance in position. Not just location. And then now he's all the way up to the book. And he says, oh, right. There is nothing and nobody higher than me now. And then he's finally convinced. And then he sees a little boy who's brave. And he says to the little boy, well, what are you doing? He says, I'm praying. And he says, well, to whom? And he says, well, and he just points up. And Horville looks up and he says, well, I see a floor. I don't hear a shuffling up there. I just see clouds. Well, who are you praying to? He says, God. And Horville says, you mean there's someone that's higher than me? Yes, there is. And so he summons the bug. Bug, make me God. And give me the kind of position that only God could do. Zap! He's back in the basement. No. Knowing all those other people, he's successful at their jobs. But that's what Jesus did. Though he was in the form of God, Jesus did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. He took the lowest position. If that's part of riding a roller coaster with Jesus, you want to go for a ride?
Yeah.
Would you get in the car if Jesus was next to you? Talking about twists. The chief priests and scribes, they twisted the truth so bad it was no longer recognizable. They were looking for testimony against Jesus, it says, to put him to death, but they found none. So some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, we heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands. But even on this, their testimony did not agree. Twisting the truth. Just a minute, detail, too. That's all I have to do. Take a detail out of context. That'll work, too. Exaggerate. Huh? They might seem like little things, little twists, but they can be devastating when it comes to the truth. Why would anyone take that roller coaster ride with Jesus? With all that, the ups and downs, twists and turns, why would anyone do that? Probably because we know how the journey ends. Can I show the last tape, the last video? This is the fire ride. Continue. take that line of Jesus where the car next to you. You see, Jesus' whole coaster ride is not like an amusement park. You go through the ride and you get to the same place you started from, and then you circle around again and get in the line again and do it again. Jesus' ride takes us to where there is the most wonderful vistas imaginable. And that's the kingdom of God. And he has prepared the way for each and every one of us to get there with him. As he says, he will come again and take us to himself. And that's a promise which is more certain than that car landing back on that track. More certain for anyone who dares to take a roller coaster ride with Jesus. We'll sing on end of the day. Response to hear us, O God, is your mercy is great. In Jesus, you came among us as a suffering servant. Give your church humility. Redeem your people from pride and the certainty that we always know your will. Heal us and empower us to confess Christ crucified. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In creation, life springs from death. Redeem your creation, awaiting resurrection. restore lost habitats and endangered species, create new possibilities for areas affected by drought or flooding, grant relief from natural disasters such as the tornadoes that have ripped through the south recently, nurture new growth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
On the cross, Jesus joined all who feel forsaken. Abide with those who are condemned to death. Defend those who are falsely accused. Console and strengthen those who are mocked and bullied. Accompany all who suffer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You called followers to tend Jesus' body in death. Sustain hospice workers and funeral directors. Bless this congregation's ministries at time of death. Those who plan and lead funerals, those who prepare meals, all who offer support and grief. We pray for those who are grieving, especially the family and friends of Reese Johnson, who tragically was killed, took his own life recently. May your spirit of love sustain and guide them as they face a situation filled with many questions and few answers. Hear us, O God. You inspired the centurion to confess Jesus as your son. We praise you for the faith you have given to people of all places and times. Give us also such faith to trust the promises of baptism, and with them look to the resurrection of the dead. Guide us in all moments of bewilderment or confusion. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We entrust ourselves and our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Holy God, our living water and our merciful guide, together with rivers and seas, wells and springs, we bless and magnify you. You led your people Israel through the desert and provided them water from the rock. We praise you for Christ, our rock and our water, who joined us in our desert, pouring out his life for the world. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life, death, and resurrection, we await your salvation for all this thirsty world. Pour out your spirit on this holy food and on all who are gathered for this feast. Wash away our sin, that we may be revived for our journey by the love of Christ. Through him all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, through the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us, saying, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. This is the body of Christ given to you.
Amen.
This is the blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remember, our annual meeting is next.